Hot copy today, our guest has long been known as a man of action. Former Senator and Philippine Red Cross Chairman Richard Gordon is making a political comeback. Here's a look at his track record.
A volunteer of the Philippine National Red Cross for over 40 years, Red Cross Chairman Richard Gordon is the iconic action man with a commendable track record in public service. In his mid-20s, he was the youngest delegate to the 1971 Constitutional Convention. He became Olongapo City Mayor in 1980. As a local executive, he transformed Olongapo from being a sin city into a community worthy of emulation. Re-elected mayor of Olongapo City by a landslide victory, he opposed the removal of the U.S. naval base in Subic Bay. In 1992, then-President Cory Aquino appointed Gordon chairman of the Subic Bay Metropolitan Authority. He was later replaced as he found himself at odds with the Estrada administration. When U.S. troops pulled out after the Pinatubo eruption, he led the conversion of the naval facility into a freeport zone. In 1998, he launched but later gave up his presidential bid. In 2001, as Secretary of Tourism under the Arroyo administration, he put the Philippines on the world tourism map and made it a magnet for visitors through his award-winning Wow Philippines campaign. In 2004, he finished sixth in the senatorial race and crafted measures such as the automated election system law. In 2010, he again joined the presidential derby but later conceded the race to Senator Noynoy Aquino. This year, he mends ties with former political rivals and makes another bid for a Senate seat under the opposition's United Nationalist Alliance.
All right, joining us on Hot Copy, United Nationalist Alliance senatorial candidate Richard Gordon is with us this morning.
Good morning, sir. So good to see you.
Nax, thank you. Okay, first question is, why did you join and choose UNA?
No other game in town.
No, why UNA?
Parties, wala namang ideologies and parties. Eh. I think some of the Liberal Party leaders wanted me, but I think some people didn't want me. And so... UNA is an alliance. It's really not, in the real strict sense of the word, a political party. So I still have my bagumbayan.
Mm-mm. That's your political party.
Yeah. So this is a vehicle. In the classic sense of a political party, that's the definition. Parties do not exist here. A group of persons who pursue a particular ideology, try to seek power so that they can implement it. In that sense, UNA tries to do that, but in reality it's composed of different personalities, and UNA is a newly formed coalition and party.
Because people have said, I've heard critics say that Richard Gordon is a mismatch with UNA. He doesn't belong there. I mean, number one is you and President Era. That makes, like, it's really strange bedfellows in politics.
Isn't it better to unify rather than to divide? Diba? At saka, you cannot have a situation where you categorize people. If your husband categorizes you, then you don't grow anymore. You know, you have to allow people to grow.
How did you, nagbati kayo, clearly? Who invited you to join UNA?
No, all of them.
All of them?
All of them. Okay. JPE was, of course, I've known JPE all my life. No? And of course, Jojo Binay told me a long time ago, we'd like to have you in UNA. You know, once upon a time, June Magsaysay asked me if I could join the Liberal Party, and I said, bahala kayo, mag-offer kayo. But wala naman nag-offer na afterwards, because I think they forced him to join the Liberal Party, they forced him to run. I don't know.
But what's it like, your relationship with Erap now, considering...
Remember.
Really, because Erap, I covered you in Subic.
Yes, I remember.
When you were being kicked out of Subic by Erap, I was there to cover it, and I would have to say, that's like a life-changing moment.
Life-changing moment in the sense that when you can see the things that you gave your life to, you know, broken and, you know, and scattered. No, but to me, Erap was my friend before that. I was the first guest speaker of Erap, who was a non-president in Pinaglabanan. Up to that time, I was the youngest delegate of the Constitutional Convention. Akong kinuha niyang unang-unang non-presidential, non-president.
Pero,
and at the same time, magkaibigan kami yan. We were both in the movies. I was the lawyer of the movie industry. I was an exhibitor. He would come to Olongapo. He would drink hard liquor. I would drink...
Hard liquor too?
Diet time.
Okay, but how did you make peace?
No, ganun naman kami. Madali kami magkaibigan eh. You know, we see each other in the funeral parlor. Una, nakikita kami sa mga funeral. Sabi ko, oh, dito lang tayo sa patay nagkikita. Tatawa kami. Tapos sabi, para yoyosi muna ako. Tama na yung sigurilyo mo.
Mga
ganun.
You
know, we yeah, you know.
Uh-oh.
And even while he was president, he asked me, he invited me when he went to Subic. Pero didn't really want to remove me, I think. And na-intriga lang yan.
You think so?
Yeah, I told
but
him that.
Have you forgiven him?
Oh, I mean, you know, you don't want to create enemies for life. You don't gain anything by it. And when you grow older, you'll say, oh, ba't pa kami nag-away nun? I'm sure he's saying that.
Yeah.
And we're both happy we're friends again.
Okay.
Because Arab is really a lovable character. Mabait yun eh. Masaya kami, masaya kami nga.
Okay, now, Mitos Magsaysay is another. I mean, people have often asked, I mean, locally or not.
Well, they belong to the upper side of the tracks in Olongapo. We've always been considered as the upstarts, you know. My parents were high school graduates. The Mitos is not really a Magsaysay. She's Magsaysay by marriage, but most of the time, the Magsaysays were the landlords of Sambales, no, in the sense, no? Eh, kami, in the order of things, there would be a clash. That's why when I ran for the Constitutional Convention, it's the first time a Gordon ever came out into the provincial politics. And I topped the elections in spite of the opposition of Mito's father-in-law.
Okay.
And because their slate was full. Their slate was full. They had a cousin, they had another running. So sabi ko, well, talagang ganyan eh. You have, you know, this country has really, is not really based I keep trying to be a principled politics. But, you know, in the same manner that many of our presidents lost their way because the politics turned sour. Because they are victimized by the system.
Mm-mm.
I try to avoid that.
But you know that Una, I mean, this is not my opinion, but it's been called by some as the Trapo Coalition.
Propaganda lang yan. I can call that, you know. Sino ba ang campaign manager ng araw ng panahon ni Gloria? Di ba si Paul Aquino? Di ba? Di ba yung sa nakaraan yung Idayan pa?
That's the father of BAM.
Yeah, sino ba ang kasama nila ngayon? Di ba, you know, remember Frank? Frank is a good friend of mine. But, you know, we were together, and then one day he says, come over to Iloilo, and then all of a sudden, he's against the president. When I was in the cabinet...
You mean GMA?
Yeah, when I was in the cabinet, I was the hard-hitting cabinet. I would tell the president what I thought about what was happening. And Dinky and Deles would say, tama na, Dick, tama na, hirap na yung presidente. And then all of a sudden, they were the ones who jumped ship. So, ako naguguluhan, quite frankly. But... you have to stay the course in a country that has mishmash political, interests. You have to stay the course. If you don't stay the course, you'll be lost.
Okay.
That's why most of our presidents get lost.
Now, is this why you want to go back to the Senate?
I love this country. That's why I'm running. I'm not running to secure title. Galing na ako dyan. I was the youngest delegate. Kung title lang, sikat ako, youngest delegate. Sumumpa sa akin yung presidente. I was mayor.
How many terms were you senator to?
One term lang ako. One term. And I did... automated election, I did international humanitarian law,
term.
I did tourism law, I did many things.
Now, do you regret running for the presidency
no,
in 2010?
No. I would do it again. I enjoyed it. Why?
Do you think
because
so?
I was able to say what I wanted to say. I'm a very passionate, very emotional, very deliberate person in that sense because I wanted to prove to the country that we can talk issues. We can talk about what we need to do for the country. You cannot inherit the presidency. You cannot buy the presidency. People ought to take a look at their candidates, use critical analysis and say, I'm not going to get your t-shirt. I'm not going to get you because you're the son of this. I'm not going to get you because this person died. I'm going to get you because you are the one fit to govern.
Now, do you think Pinoy inherited the presidency?
Yes.
He did?
Yes, in all certain terms.
Okay.
Would he have run if his mother had not died? You know that he didn't want to run. And when his mother died, Rojas had to take a back step, and Pinoy had to come in. That's the reality. I'm not hitting Pinoy. That's just the reality. I like Pinoy. He's a good person, essentially.
Okay. Now, rate his administration, 10 being the highest.
Well, you know, I don't go into that rating game. There are good things that he is doing. I like the fight against corruption, but I don't think you should... one swallow does not a season make. Hindi porque tinira mo si Corona. Corona was a dead meat the moment he got impeached. He was dead meat. But insofar as I'm concerned, ang mali doon, yung example nung kumukuha kayo ng ebidensya na hindi nararapat gamitin at ang nangyayari, gagayahin ng mga pulisyan yung mga, you know, evidence that was obtained illegally. To me, there was illegal evidence obtained and I cannot divorce myself from my law. I mean, I'm a biggest fan of St. Thomas More. You know, he refused to bow to the king, his best friend, because the law was the law.
Okay, all right, Saba.
Oh, Saba. The Philippine claim to Saba has always been sagging. Di ba sabay?
Okay, but
because hindi tayo, hindi tayo consistent.
Was Saba mishandled by Pinoy?
Saba has always been mishandled by everyone, but in this particular instance, it was he was woefully ineffective. The administration was woefully ineffective. Pinabayaan siya ng mga advisor niya. The president should never talk in these cases. It should be the foreign secretary who should talk because he painted himself into a corner, as he painted the Kiramstro into a corner. Eh, binong sabi niya, pag bumalik kayo, lagot kayo dito, kukulong ko kayo. Tapos siya naman, he's saying, oh, he's falling all over the place to placate Malaysia. You don't have to placate Malaysia. Malaysia will understand that you have to defend your people. But he could say, boss, mga kaibigan, mas malaking interest natin sa ASEAN. These guys, they want to just state their claim. Pabayaan nyo na, bunga na, kakausapin ng mga tao kayan, quietly, dadalhin natin sila pabalik. But you know, the Kirams have always been mishandled by everyone. And ngayon, sumabog, they're not in control. They could not control. It's really management by the seat of your pants. You cannot do that. You have to be deliberate. That's why you have cabinet officials who must tell you what to do. Ang lumalabas ngayon, to placate Malaysia, you have to hit your people. And up to now, today, in the headlines, he's saying again, you know, face the consequences, you know, unconditional surrender. Hindi mo sinasabi sa tao mo yan. Because those people have a right, because even insofar as private right is concerned, nagbabayad ng rental, hindi naman madidinahin ng Malaysia yan. And besides, binenta nila sa Longa says, binenta, pinahiram ng Malaysia sa kay that Dutch guy, and then later on pinahiram ng Dutch guy to them, and then they gave it to Malaysia, which is illegal.
All right. Now, in defense of the president, Pinoy had said, number one, if you want to state your claims, you don't do it that way. That's a hopeless cause. The manner. Number two, he had said, what do you expect Malaysia to do? In effect, I mean, given it's their territory, you come in armed, what would they do? We would do the same thing.
That's correct. I will concede that. Okay. But the first question you asked.
So Pinoy was correct there?
No. In the case of Malaysia.
Okay.
In the case of Malaysia. But in the case of our country, does Pinoy believe that we still have a law that has not been amended that claims Sabah? I think it is 5446, no? There where it says Philippine territory, comprised of all the territories inherited, et cetera, et cetera, from the Treaty of Paris, including our claim to Sabah, North Borneo. Eh, the president has got to state that. Mukhang nakalimutan niya yan. Afterthought na lang, uy, may claim nga pala tayo. So, i-pursue natin ngayon sa ICJ. Yun ang nangyari. But sa kanya, ang importante sa kanya, eh, nagugulo itong mga ito. Teka, sorry ha, kaibigan ha, ayaw mo itong bahala dito. Papakita akong tough guy ako dyan. Oy, mauwi na kayo, huhulihin ko kayo. That's not the way. Because these guys already feel like, they're like arm. Always, hindi pinapansin ng mga pangulo, inuutu-utu lamang. Pagkatapos pagdating ng labanan, eh, bigla silang titingnan ngayon ng aasikasuhin. Pagkatapos pabago-bago ang policy, hindi pwedeng ganun. When the moment that happened, he should have convoked his advisors. I will not talk. Oh, Mr. Ambassador, you talk to the Malaysians, and I will send somebody to go to talk to these people, mga kaibigan nitong sila Kiram, and I'll say, don't worry, we'll handle it. Kung nagkulang ako sa inyo, patawarin niyo ako, bumalik na kayo dito, ipaglalaban ko yung claim niyo.
Okay.
He did not do that. What did he say? You're outlaws, practically. You're criminals. When you come back here, lagot kayo. You're a Filipino president. What kind of message do you think the Malaysians got? Ah, yung presidente nila, pinabayaan na sila. Oh, pwede na natin upakan yan. Hindi upakan nila. That's what happened. And when Filipinos die, you now have a bigger problem, a slippery slope. Madulas na yan because there is now national emotion. Filipino yan eh. These are Tausug Filipinos. They are historically lapu-lapu. They fought against the colonial invader. They will die. Imagine, sabi mo pa ngayon, oh, binayaran lang kayo. Pag binayaran ka, hindi ka magpapakamatay. Pera yun eh. Ang pinaglalaban nito, yung historic claim nila, umuwi lang sila sa homeland nila. Pinahiram lang namin sa inyo, gusto namin baguhin yan. Hindi ko may pinapansin ng gobyerno. So we're making a statement that we're willing to die for. Death before dishonor. Parang ganun, hindi ba?
Okay. Now, do you miss this kind of intelligent discussion in the Senate? That at least, even if you disagree or agree, there's at least some kind of intelligent discourse.
Yes, I think you need that in the Senate. You lost that. Did we talk about our Scarborough Shoals in the Senate? Did anybody say, Mr. President, magkaibigan naman tayo eh, Brother Senator. Huwag niyong gamitin yung barko na bagong-bago na 46 years old na galing sa Amerikano. Ba't yung gagamitin yan? Magiging naval man of war na yan. Huhulihin natin. Dati hinuhuli natin yung mga Chinese sa Palawan, hinuhuli natin sila. Walang angala. Sige, hinuli niyo yung fisherman, balik niyo sa amin. Ganon. Eh ngayon, hinuli ng sundalo natin. O di sabi ng China, litlito, yabang-yabang yun, iwala kayong barko, ang Navy nyo, all coast, no guard. O di binalikan tayo.
Oh.
Wala naman kayong Air Force, all air, no force. Ngayon, nakakapasok pa ba ang Pilipino doon sa Scarborough Shoals? No more. Ask them, ask the government, nakakapasok pa ba yung mga tao natin, mga isda dyan? Hindi. Nung araw, in-interview ko yung mga tao dyan, just about 2 months ago, sabi lang nung araw, we will go inside, pupunta yung China, kakatok doon sa butang, anong ulam nyo? Anong sigarilyo nyo? Palit tayo. Ngayon, wala
na. How should the administration have treated the China issue?
China is a very personalistic nation.
Yes, yeah. And actually, I wanted to ask you, because the ambassador, in several dinners with people, have said, your president has brought it out in the public. They say it to people they meet.
Totoo yan. Because ang problema ni Pinoy, because, you know, he's, like I said, kumisang kulang doon sa nuances of foreign policy. It's not his strongest suit. You do not negotiate in public. You do not posture in public. You make sure, ano ba talaga ang national interest natin dyan? Ano ba talaga ang dapat natin gawin reaction dyan? Now, with the China, kaya mahal tayo ng China nung araw, tayong unang country na nag-recognize sa kanila. Whether you like Marcos or not, he did recognize China.
Okay.
And Imelda Marcos went there and nagmano pa kay Mao Zedong. So mahal na mahal sila. Dapat personal ang relationship. But of course, kasabihin mo sa China, personal tayo, pero boss, ang laki naman ninyo eh. Patulong naman kami dito sa mga kasama namin sa Japan na may issue kayo eh. Siyempre, hahanapan mo yung mga issue. Even Vietnam, they have an issue. And they gave Vietnam a bloody nose when they, after the Vietnam War, they attacked Vietnam over land. They gave each other a bloody nose. Tapos dun sa Paracels, tinira rin nila ang Vietnam. Ganyan yan. Ang China, ayaw nilang mangyari dati yung tinake over sila ng foreign powers. So, pagkadating sa teritory, aawayin nila yung India, nagbakbakan sila. Aawayin nila yung Russia, nagbakbakan sila. So, ang tagal ko na sinasabi sa Senado, dapat pinag-usapan natin yan. Sa Senado, matagal ko na sinasabi, kailangan meron tayong Air Force para pag may mag-i-intrude sa atin, at least may flyover ng Air Force, mag-iisip na yon. At saka dapat, pinag-aaralan natin, kung ang claim natin yan, dapat naandun na tayo. Buti pa nga si Congressman Abla, nilagay yung bandila ng Pilipinas dyan eh. Umangal ba ang China nun? Wala. Nung umalis na ang bases, wala na. Wala na tayong protection. So far as I'm concerned, mismanagement. Doon sa hostage crisis, mismanaged rin. Galit ang China sa atin. O, di ba? Mismanaged natin yan. Walang nakulong. Di ba? Tapos pinag-usapan pa kung ano-ano, pero galit pa rin ang China sa atin. Pagkatapos yung nangyari sa Scarborough Shoals, we lost our bananas. Kaya nga, like the Philippine claim to Sabah is saging, our relationship with China is based on saging again. Saging diplomacy. Tinanggal na yung saging natin.
Ang dami mong na-coin na terms
kayo. No, hindi.
No,
I was a debater in UP.
Sabah, saging, and then saging diplomacy.
Yeah, saging diplomacy.
Like Gordon,
talagang binabalatan tayo saging. Uy, pangit yung packing nyo, may sakit yung saging nyo. So, nataranta na naman tayo. Ngayon, tinamaan pa tayo ng Pablo. Yung saging natin sa Compostela, walang trabaho doon. 150,000 people are now out of work. The initiative of Marcos to China came because China was intruding in our inside affairs. They were funding the NPA. The okay. Maoists. Remember that?
All right.
The same thing with Sabah. Mustafa was fooling around in Mindanao. Kaya naggawa siya ng jabida, rightly or wrongly, kung talagang lulusubin niya yung Malaysia, hindi natin alam because in-exposed ni President Aquino. So the long and the short of it is, nations go by their national interests. Hindi pwedeng pride yan ng personal ng presidente na napahiya ako dyan, napapahiya ako sa inyo. Kaya ngayon, papakita ko ako siga dito sa Pilipinas. Sisitayin ko ito mga tao natin. Mga Pilipino yan, unang-una. Pakita mo naman na mahal mo yung bansa, pasabihin mo sa Malaysia, oy, Mr. Secretary, you go there and tell them, assure them, na hindi natin pinakana ito. Ang may pakana niya, sila-sila. Kakausapin ko rin ito, ayamon, kung na, hindi kayo nasama dun sa Bangsamoro problem, kung hindi kayo napapansin dati, kung ibigay sa atin halimbawa yan, di mayaman ang Pilipinas. Hindi ba? So dapat kunin mo yan. May claim ka, may papel ka eh.
Welcome back to Hot Coffee. With us is Una Senatorial candidate Richard Gordon. Every time you're on the show, parang I feel the table is about, it's like it's so hot.
It's because life must be exciting.
Okay.
It's so boring here.
Okay.
You can predict the Filipino eh.
Yeah.
Uy, masamang tao yan. Oh, okay. Lahat, hindi sasabihin ko anong gusto.
Ito, very quick questions. We don't have enough time, but we
quick
need
answers.
To bullet. JC De Los Reyes is your relative. He was on the show. He said, ironically, there's a photo. See, they prepared it.
Oh, sige.
Tell me, you're not in speaking terms.
I speak to him. He even kisses me every time he sees me. because I'll tell you, in our family, we're very contentious.
Okay.
He has the right to say what he wants to say. But he has got to be accountable for it.
Okay.
Remember, you have to be accountable to your country, first to God, to your country, to your family.
Okay. Now, very quickly, you are with UNA. You have always been known as an upright politician. What do you make of Port Irene? Accusations of smuggling with Enrile, and now the COA, where their PDAF went to a bogus NGO. Would you tolerate something
see,
like that?
I will not. I took it off subic, di ba?
All right.
Because in exposed I mean, to smuggling.
No, no. Sasabihin ko siya.
Hindi ako selective. Yung nagsasabi niyan, nung ginagawa sa subic yan, sino nagpaalis niyan? Ako. Dahil may smuggling. Pinatunayan ko may smuggling.
Mm-mm.
Pero doon sa Irene, sino nag-i-smuggle? Ba't di nyo sabihin? Yun ang problema. Madaling magpakalat ng balita. Pero ang talagang proof of the pudding is, eto si ganito nag-i-smuggle. Eto si ganito nag-i-smuggle. Etong in-smuggle nila. You know what I did? Lahat ng tax doon sa Subic, mayroon akong libro ganyan karami, ganito kalaki na wala sa amin.
Mm-mm.
At alam ko kung sino nag-i-smuggling nung panahon na yan.
Mm-mm.
Sinabi
Mm-mm.
ko yan.
Now, but given that clearly there's a lot of it.
Tingin mo, Port Irene, anong dadalhin mo doon? Mahirap magpagawa basta-basta ng pre-port. So, pagka may pre-port, dapat hindi pinalalabas yung kotse. Eh, ang gobyerno mismo nagpalabas ng kotse. Pumayag sila eh. Pangalawa, hindi ko din na-define dyan, ha? Dapat, kung may nag-i-smuggling sa Manila, yung bigas, may ni-smuggling sa Subic, $650 million, pesos. Bakit hindi hinahanap ng gobyerno? Di ba? Bakit yung Subic hindi na kasing vibrant as before? Because pinalis ko nga yung smuggling na yan dahil nasira, we lost our way. It was a free port. Volunteers made Subic happen. They were honest. They were working without pay. Nabighani lahat ang mga pangulo nagpunta ron.
Mm-mm.
Nung umalis na ako, medyo may smuggling dito, may smuggling doon, tanggal dito, tanggal doon, nakalimutan na yung values. When you lose your vision, you lose your values.
Mm-hmm.
When you lose your values, you lose your voluntarism.
Okay.
Then you lose your victory.
Now, all these exposés against Port Irene, against COA, do you see this technically? I mean, it's...
Should I now make an expose on the president? Oy, bakit kayo nagpako na $650 million dyan? Paliwanag nyo nga sa akin yan. Bakit walang na-convict dun sa tinatawag nating hostage crisis? Bakit ganyan ang ga-handling nyo dyan? Namatay na ang Pilipino. Sinasabi nyo pa, oh, mali kayo, mali kayo. Excuse me. Fair game. Politics yan. Huwag ko kayo magagalit sa akin because I say it frankly. I think you should be happy because dapat nakikita niyo yung point of view nung dalawa. So long as it's not personal.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Pero kung paninira, wala kayong katunayan, sasabihin niyo ganun, mali kayo yan.
So you think this is an attack on UNA?
Alam mo, ang politika natin, UNA, oh, tuta. Di ba nung araw, tuta. Classified ka na,
yeah.
Tuta.
Yeah.
Bakit? Gusto mo sabihin ko sa asawa ko, sabihin mo sa akin, under desire ako, hindi na ako mag-grow? Gusto mo sabihin mo doon sa tao, ikaw, hindi ka na mag-grow dahil
Mm-mm.
ikaw, wala kang alam? Of course not.
Okay.
Reality manifests itself in profiles.
Okay, all right. Very quickly, Audibus J is asking, are Red Cross Foundation funds safe since you are running again? Somebody asked that? That's
Excuse
not me.
Excuse me. Laban sa limang banta.
I was paid
several millions, or whatever your name is. I was paid several millions. It's there.
Okay.
The safeguard fund. Binayad sa akin, pay to Richard Gordon,
okay.
Ibinigay ko sa Red Cross. Tanayin niyo yung Procter & Gamble, pinabura ko yung cheque, ibigay niyo sa Philippine Red Cross.
Okay, all right. I'm just gonna read this.
Well, read it.
Mang Pandoy, you're criticized for your temper and arrogance.
Well, I'm human, you know?
Okay.
Tell me what human being does not have a temper.
Are you always angry?
No, I'm not angry. I'm happy.
Okay, all right.
Why do you think I never lost an election till the presidency and I didn't lose because of my temper. I lost because kalaban ko, malaking tao.
Okay, quickly. Okay. Now, Silet is asking, what can you do to improve the lives of people with disability? Quickly.
If I can do Red Cross and I have helped a lot of people and I have done persons with disability, tanongin niyo yung tahanan walang hagdan. Tingin niyo yung Subic. Lahat may way for the wheelchair. Tanongin niyo doon sa automated election law. There must be a special provision for persons with disability so they can vote.
Okay, all right.
If I do this with the ETAS, I can do it too.
Now, we're gonna go, but before we go, Teddy Loxin Jr. is your fan. I want you to smile before we go.
I've been smiling. You're not looking at me.
All right.
You're always thinking about your husband.
Twitter.
Ah,
okay, here's Teddy Loxin. I admire this guy, referring to you, for tossing away a
senatorial victory
for the elusive dream of presidency
you,
in 2010.
Thank you, Teddy.
Okay.
I can sacrifice
so you
that.
You took a risk.
I could have won easily, di ba?
As a senator then.
But I told everybody, hindi ako mananalo dyan because wala tayong pera. But I tried to write when I was in Subic.
Mm-mm.
But I tried to run when I was mayor and Subic was removed. I went to Subic because kawawa ang tao. Walang trabaho. Walang trabaho.
Okay. Don't hate me for this. It's 8:56. I'm giving you 20 seconds. Why should they pick you to go back to the Senate? And your number, you are G.
Because I love the country, and I've always loved the country, and I show you that. Because I think there is no focus in our country. Look at this interview, we're going everywhere, but there was no focus on what we could do to our country. Because our country is not fast enough, that's why we're left behind. We're not friendly enough, that's why we're corrupt. We are not flexible enough, that's why we get into trouble all the time, and we're not forward-looking. And above all, we don't want to be always first, always ready, always there. That's my life. In the Red Cross, I say always first, always ready, always there. We want to culture mediocrity, and that's what we've done. We want the handout rather than the hand, all hands working together. We want to be treated, oh, mabait ka naman, kahit nasalbahe ka. And when the people
that's
are not
true,
around, that's true.
That's very true.
That's true. At pagka nakaharap yung tao, hindi kayo magsasalita, magpapalitrato kayo. Pagtalikod, okay, may litrato na ako, lalagay pa salas, pero pag nasira yun, titirahin mo lang titirahin.
Mm.
We have to change our mindset about ourselves. We have to define our country. And we have not defined our country until now. That's why I put lapu-lapu in the monument there. We are sa manlulupig, di ka pasisil, at ready tayong mamatay ng dahil sa'yo.
Okay, all right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank
Richard
you.
Gordon, your number?
Number 15.
15,
yes.
in the ballot.
I'm not a number. I'm Dick Gordon. Look at my character. Look at my track record. Don't look at the number.